Hi everyone, in this video we'll talk about waiting line simulation. I will go over an example of the waiting line simulation model with ATM machines. But first, let's talk briefly about simulation. Simulation is a quantitative method in decision making. We usually use simulation to learn about the real system by building and experimenting with a model that represents the system. A simulation model usually contains a mathematical expression of all the model that describes how to compute output variables given the various input variables. By using mathematical models, we can represent real systems with mathematical formulas, and we can experiment with the model before we actually take any action in the real system. That's the main value of simulation models. There are differences between simulation models and optimization models. The objective of simulation is not to find optimal solutions. The objective of simulation is to investigate how real systems behave, how real systems act based on changes of the inputs. Then we can make decisions based on experimental analysis of the simulation model. Let's look at the diagram of a simulation model in the textbook. We have a model which is represented by a mathematical model in this case. The model includes outputs. The outputs are the expected outcomes of the model, such as waiting time, total profit, system risks, etc. Basically, anything that we expect as our outcomes are considered the outputs of a simulation model. We have several inputs that go into the model. Controllable inputs are the ones that we have full control, like product price, number of products that we're going to produce, number of stocks we need to purchase, or number of check-in counters, etc. And we have probabilistic input, which we have less control of that, or in some cases, no control at all. Probabilistic inputs represent the uncertainty in the system, or we call this stochastic. That's why we need to use a probabilistic distribution function to represent this type of input. Even though we cannot have full control of these inputs, we could actually understand how they behave, and based on their characteristics, we can build a model to examine the changes in probabilistic inputs and how the whole system behaves to these changes. The simulation experiment would allow us to form what-if scenarios and decide the values of controllable inputs that will make the system work. That is the basic idea of simulation. In this video, we will look at waiting line simulation models. Waiting line simulation model is a very interesting case in which we can see how the system operates, how changes of inputs will affect the outputs, and how the system will actually behave based on these changes. This model sometimes is called a dynamic simulation model, which allows us to see how the system changes over time. This is also called discrete event simulation model because we are using inputs as the event at discrete points of time. This is a very popular method in operations research and decision making. So let's look at this simple waiting line decision problem at a bank. A bank that has several branches, and each of them has installed one ATM machine to serve customers. The main concern is that with one ATM machine, how many customers have to wait in line and how much is the waiting time? Thus, the amount of time that each customer has to wait, the number of customers that have to stay in line are the major concerns to the bank. The simulation will assist the bank manager to decide whether one ATM machine is enough for this certain location based on the customer demand. This model can be expanded to two ATM machines, three ATM machines, etc. And you can see that this model can be applied to many different research areas. A common research topic in aviation is the number of check-in counters at airports. How many is enough? How many is too many? You don't want to put so many check-in counters because it's not cost-effective. But if you put an insufficient numbers of check-in counters, it will result in a long waiting line and long waiting time, which will affect customer service. We can see similar situations in restaurants, hotels, and train stations. So everywhere we see certain waiting line problems, the decision makers must understand how the systems works and behave before they can make the final decisions. Having said that, this decision approach is popular in many research areas, and it's important to learn how it works and how to develop and learn a simulation model. Back to our example, the waiting line model has two events. The customer inter-arrival time shows how frequent customers arrive to the ATM machine. Service time shows how long it takes for a customer to complete transactions at the ATM. These two inputs will have influence on the waiting line and the waiting time. You can read more about waiting line theory in Chapter 11. Note that customer inter-arrival time and customer service time are probabilistic inputs, which we do not have much control of. However, we do have control over the number of ATM machines that we can put in each location. And yes, that is a controllable input. And this will be the decision we have to make. As discussed before, although we do not have control over probabilistic inputs, we do have enough information to know the probabilistic distributions of these factors. For example, based on past research, a researcher found that customer inter-arrival time usually follow the uniform distribution. This is the formula for the uniform distribution function that represents a so-called inter-arrival time, which is the time between two successive arrivals. The inter-arrival time has two major parameters, the minimum inter-arrival time and the maximum inter-arrival time. Again, this information can be achieved by collecting data over time at that location. In this example, the problem shows that we have the minimum inter-arrival time of 0, or we call A. That means the lap time between two arrivals is 0. The maximum inter-arrival is 5 minutes, and also called B.
So the minimum arrival time plus the random number
is entry number between 0 and 1, and I will show you later how to get this number, times the difference between maximum and the minimum interarrival times, which is B minus A. In this example, we have A is 0 and B is 5 minutes. So the uniform distribution function of the interarrival time looks like this, 5 times R. And this is a graph of the interarrival time using the uniform distribution. We can see that the graph shows a uniform distribution. The inter-arrival time will be any value between 0 and 5 minutes, and we can experiment with this value using the random number. The second probabilistic input is customer service time, which indicates how much time each customer needs to complete all transactions. Customer may have come for some quick cash, withdrawal, deposit, or other purposes. So this service time varies. But then again, by collecting past data from similar ATMs at similar locations, we can perform some analysis to find more information about the service time. In this example, the customer service time at this ATM machine follows a normal distribution. The normal distribution has two major parameters, the mean and the standard deviation. In this example, mean is 2 minutes and standard deviation is 0.5 minutes. There is an Excel function that helps us get the normal probability given mean and standard deviation. Now we have enough information and we can start working on developing the simulation model for this waiting line problem. The simulation had a controllable input, which is the number of ATM machines. We have two probabilistic inputs, inter-arrival time and service time. The outcomes of this model are operating characteristics, such as number of customers that have to wait in line, minimum and maximum waiting times, probability that a customer has to wait more than 1 minute, and percentage of utilization, which shows how many percent of the time that the ATM machine is used. That means the effectiveness of this ATM utilization. All of these operating characteristics can be determined through the simulation experiment, and that helps decision makers decide whether they need to add another ATM machine or not. In order to build the simulation model, it is important that we understand the simulation process, algorithm, and mathematical expressions. We'll be using Excel for this purpose, but before doing that, I will explain this algorithm. This is a simple one, and it is presented in a flowchart, so it is easy to understand. We start the simulation with the assumption that the start time is zero. At this start time, we have no customer, and everything starts from zero. And then we have the first customer coming. The uniform distribution function is used to generate inter-arrival time. Since the start time is zero, the customer 1 arrival times is also zero. The next customer arrival time equals to the arrival time of the previous customer plus the inter-arrival time. That seems easy enough. The completion time is the time when the customer completes all banking transactions. So if the arrival time of the second customer is greater than the completion time of the first customer, it means when the second customer comes in, the first customer has already finished all transactions, and therefore the ATM is now available. Thus, the second customers can begin using the ATM immediately. In this case, the start time of the second customer is the same as his or her arrival time. On the other hand, suppose the second customer arrives, but the first customer is still using the machine. And in this case, arrival time is less than or equal to the completion time of the first customer. Thus, the second customer has to wait until the first one completes all transactions. The formula of start time is different. Start time is equal to the completion time of the first customer. So once we find out the start time of the second customer, we can calculate the waiting time. Waiting time is equal to start time minus arrival time. It could be zero if there's no waiting time at all. Then we have the service time, which follows the normal distribution. And with the start time, we can find out the completion time. So the time that this customer finished all transactions will be equal to start time plus service time. Then we can calculate the system time, which is the total time that the customer spends in the system, including waiting time in the line plus service time. In this case, system time is equal to completion time minus arrival time. And then we use the same algorithm for the third customer, fourth customer, etc. It is recommended that we run the simulation for many trials, and the first 100 trials will be considered the startup for the simulation. Because the simulation starts from zero, we should let it run for 100 times until it gets into a normal mode, and run another 900 trials. Finally, we use these 900 trials to calculate the outcomes. So that is the process and algorithm of simulation model. Thank you, and bye now.